Oxygen in water versus oxygen in air. Humans are considered the rulers of society. Animals and plants are all subjected to their care. Humans, animals, and plants all share one thing in common. They all use oxygen within their respiratory system. It is important to note, however, that the degree in which each uses oxygen differs. Example, plants only uses oxygen at nights. Aquatic creatures are adapted to use liquefied oxygen in water. For most of the Earth's life forms, oxygen is the single most vital element. You can survive without the carbon and nitrogen in foodstuffs for weeks and can go days without taking in water, but just a few minutes without oxygen can end your life. The interplay between organism, environment, and oxygen is complex but well understood. According to scientists, oxygen in air total an average of 21% of the Earth's lower atmosphere. Liquid oxygen, on the other hand, is a mere 1% along our waterways. Oxygen accounts for one of the third most abundant element on planet Earth. Discovered in 1774, oxygen is number 8 on the periodic table of the elements and is virtually always found in gaseous form. The name comes from Greek and translates to oxygen forming, as it was once wrongly believed that oxygen was required to produce all acids. It is usually in the diatomic state, or O2, although ozone, or O3, is a common compound in the upper atmosphere. In addition to being required by almost all organisms, it is also needed for combustion. Let's focus our attention on our very aquatic creatures, or fish, shrimps to name a few. Oxygen is needed in any space used by fish to swim. The absence of oxygen will result of their death. How we do provide oxygen for our aquarium is important. Many persons use air pumps, specialized hang-on-the-back filters, sumps, powiads to name a few system. You will hear many self-professed fish keepers and know-it-all suggest that your aquarium should be heavily oxygenated to maintain your fish health. Warning, a heavily oxygenated aquarium will result in your fish death. Whenever an aquarium is fitted with a system which provides extensive amount of oxygen, lethal gas bubble disease will exist. This occurs when the gas comes out of solution inside the fish, creating bubbles in its skin and around its eyes. Excess nitrogen, however, is a far more common cause of this disease. This is known as O2 toxicity. For this situation to occur, however, your aquarium would have to have extensive highly pressurized oxygen being pumped via air system into your fish space. This topic is rarely discussed as not many persons attempt this feat. The concern for many aquarists is the reality of low oxygen with their fish space. Remember, at this point, too much oxygen in water, air becomes more than 100% saturated, that's the critical junction of survival or death for your aquarium livestock. One of the main reason why this situation is of rare occurrence amongst fish keeper is that water temperature varies. Warm air does not hold as much oxygen as cold air. Gas bubbles disease will become a problem if there is a high lingering volume of fish waste in the aquarium, along with an intense air system within your aquarium or fish space. Oxygen usage in your aquarium grows with the stock of fish you include in your aquarium. The more fish you add, the greater the volume of oxygen needed. An air system being installed in your aquarium setup is a great idea, however you should be warned that although gas bubble disease is rare, you fish may die as it fights constantly to swim against the currents being produced by your air filter in your aquarium. Remember, every fish species has a preferred filtration mechanism, which influences oxygen within your aquarium space. While plants provide oxygen during the day for your water, at nights they require oxygen. A system without mechanical or biological filtration is best kept outdoors where the air is cool. That way more oxygen exists in the water space. It is hoped that I did not bore you to death. Join me next time as I share another interesting video relating to fish keeping. Remember to like, share and subscribe. Much love to all.